The inaugural flight of the Vulcan launcher, from Florida's Space Coast on Monday, was a resounding success. With precision and accuracy, it propelled a commercial robotic lander towards the moon, ensuring that ULA's flawless track record remains untarnished. As United Launch Alliance rejoiced in their triumphant launch from Cape Canaveral, their primary client faced some unexpected challenges with their lunar lander. These obstacles posed a threat to their mission of reaching the moon. And for the very first time, the B-4 engines took flight on a rocket, showcasing their incredible power. Despite these hurdles, Astrobotic Technologies' Peregrine lunar lander appeared to be on the right trajectory. Thanks to the remarkable performance of ULA's Vulcan Centaur, during its historic maiden voyage into the vastness of space. Yeehaw! I am so thrilled, I can't tell you how much! Exclaimed Tory Bruno, ULA's president and CEO, shortly after Vulcan's departure from Cape Canaveral.
Hey, is there anything else that you want to share with the audience?
I am so proud of this team. Oh my gosh, this has been years of hard work. So far, this has been an absolutely beautiful mission. Back to the moon and off to our next burn where we will do our final payload deployment to that heliocentric orbit.
Vulcan rocket lived up to the moment Monday. It took nearly a decade for ULA to develop it, some 4 years longer than anticipated, but the first flight took off at the opening of the launch window, on the first launch attempt. In 2015, ULA unveiled the Vulcan rocket as a response to the competition posed by SpaceX. Back then, SpaceX had already achieved a string of successful Falcon 9 launches, at a significantly lower cost per flight, compared to ULA's Atlas V and Delta IV rockets. However, SpaceX had not yet accomplished the feat of recovering and reusing Falcon 9 boosters, which would further reduce costs and increase the frequency of flights. Prior to this, ULA had enjoyed exclusive access to a highly profitable market for launching U.S. military satellites. The Atlas V and Delta IV were the only rockets certified by the Pentagon for transporting critical and expensive national security payloads into orbit. However, SpaceX filed a lawsuit against the Air Force after being excluded from competing for military launch contracts. Through mediation, SpaceX eventually secured a concession that allowed the Falcon 9 rocket to be certified for launching these top priority national security satellites. Similar to ULA, SpaceX has maintained a flawless launch success record since the military's certification of the Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy. Currently, both SpaceX and ULA share the responsibility of launching military space missions. The Pentagon aims to have two independent launch providers to ensure that its satellites always have a reliable means of reaching orbit. Since the announcement of the Vulcan program, ULA has lost its dominant position in the U.S. launch market. SpaceX has now taken over that position, having launched nearly 100 rockets last year, while ULA only managed 3 launches. This was a pivotal moment for ULA, a 50-50 joint venture between Boeing and Lockheed Martin. The Vulcan rocket will replace ULA's mainstay rockets, the Atlas V and Delta IV, with lineages dating back to the dawn of the space age. Astrobotic, a Pittsburgh-based company, made history by launching the first lander under NASA's Commercial Lunar Payload Services contract. The lander successfully separated from the upper Centaur stage and began its journey towards the moon. However, a setback occurred when an anomaly prevented the lander from maintaining a stable sun-pointing orientation. The team is working to address the issue in real time and will provide updates as they analyze data. Unfortunately, without a reliable power source, the lander's mission to land on the near side of the moon on February 23 is now uncertain. The team suspects a propulsion anomaly is the cause and is troubleshooting the issue, while the spacecraft's battery rapidly depletes. Just moments before 1 p.m., the company announced a remarkable feat. They had executed an important maneuver to realign the solar panels of Peregrine towards the radiant sun. This news brought a glimmer of hope as communication was restored. However, this optimism was short-lived as a more somber message followed. The company shared their success in adjusting Peregrine's solar array, stating, "The team's ingenuity paid off, and now we are replenishing the battery with solar energy." While the mission anomaly board diligently analyzed the incoming data, they also investigated the root cause of the anomaly, a malfunction in the propulsion system. Regrettably, approximately 15 minutes later, the company delivered a disheartening update. Unfortunately, the propulsion system failure has resulted in a critical loss of propellant. Our team is tirelessly working to stabilize this situation, but given the circumstances, our priority is to maximize the scientific discoveries and data we can gather. We are currently exploring alternative mission profiles that may be viable under these circumstances. If the spacecraft's solar power positioning cannot be maintained, and it fails to execute necessary propulsion maneuvers, it risks missing the moon. The company expressed gratitude for the overwhelming support received, including social media messages, phone calls, and physical assistance. They emphasized that this unity in the face of adversity is what makes the space industry special. The Peregrine Mission 1 team extended a heartfelt thank you to everyone. NASA's CLPS program has a series of moon missions lined up, including the Griffin Lunar Lander from Astrobotic. This larger lander is scheduled for launch in 2024. Joel Kearns, NASA's Deputy Associate Administrator for Exploration in the Science Mission Directorate, highlighted that every success and setback presents an opportunity for growth and learning. He emphasized that this lesson will drive efforts to advance science, exploration, and commercial development on the moon. For the very first time, the B-4 engines took flight on a rocket, showcasing their incredible power. With the help of solid-fueled boosters, these engines generated an astonishing 2 million pounds of thrust, propelling the Vulcan rocket into the sky and piercing through a thin layer of clouds. Just a little over a minute into the launch, Vulcan surpassed the speed of sound and gracefully shed its strap-on boosters, allowing them to gracefully descend into the Atlantic Ocean. From that point onward, it was all about the B-4 engines. Each of these remarkable engines has the capability to produce over 500,000 pounds of thrust, utilizing a combination of liquefied natural gas, which is essentially methane, and liquid oxygen. These engines are crafted by Blue Origin, the space company established by the visionary billionaire, Jeff Bezos. This momentous occasion marked the first time that the B-4 engines have ever been utilized on a rocket. Rob Gagnon, ULA's telemetry commentator, calmly announced the significant milestones of the mission. The B-4 engines are performing flawlessly. The vehicle is maintaining its trajectory perfectly, everything is looking fantastic. The booster is operating smoothly and efficiently. That's it for today's episode. We hope you enjoyed it and learned something new. Please let us know what you think in the comments section down below. Your feedback is very important to us, because it helps us make better videos for you, so thank you very much and we hope to see you again next time.